everyone, welcome back to another Exos Heroes video. So today we are going through the Forgotten Memory banner or the past banner. But before that, if you wanted updated Exos Heroes content, please hit the subscribe button down below. Alrighty guys, so today we are ranking all of the heroes in the past banner. This is actually in relation to the newly dropped banner, the Choice Fate Core for the past banner. Okay, so let's start with our ranking with number 6. So what we have here is going to be Reed Marie. Unfortunately, Reed Marie had a rework already, and it did pretty much give her a little bit of a boost, but not so much. And some were actually arguing that it even made her go into a lesser form in terms of skills. But let's take a look at her passive first. So she has Focus Fire 2, clicks target with Focus Fire Mark and decreases dodge block for one round on basic attack, gains one mana when Mark target dies. Dragon Knight Blessing, of course, she is actually good with the dragon, so increases damage dealt to dragons with damage with dragon scale of order activated by 250%. Okay, and then her new passive skill would be Pirate's Pride. So grants self with Pirate's Pride mark, which allows protection from death one time. So kind of like Bathory when they have Tranquil, so protects from death. And grants skill damage immunity when marked with protection from death. Okay, so she can only be afflicted damage by your basic attack, so she's immune only one time for this one. Okay, next would be her, let's take a look at her S1. So ultimatum deals 187% damage to one enemy, afflicts target with frostbite, dealing 115% damage every turn for 2 turns. Most of her skills are actually built for PvE because actually of the damage over time, which is actually good. Then her S2 would be Total Bombardment, Record Mana 5. This used to be, I forgot the previous version of this skill, but I believe that the previous one was better than this, her current S2. So her current S2 is deals 124% piercing damage to all enemies, afflicts target with frostbite, dealing 43% damage over time for 4 turns. The reason why she's not really effective right now in PvP, because again, she's a frost hero. So if you encounter Summer's Blessing, this will not be, this will not be really good skill, especially for S1 and S2. And it also has damage over time, which is actually more useful in your PvP. In your PvE. Okay, number 5 on our list would be Emma. So Emma, the rework for her kit is actually good enough to. She was actually the one that I used before FC April for Linombe. So she was the one in the front line while the rest on the back line. So let's take a look at her skills. Her passive is Cleanse 3, cleanses damage over time and debuffs effects from an ally, gains mana when the target's health is 20% or less and the other one is 70% or more. She also has Dragon Knight Blessing. She also has Head Dragon Knight. Decreased damage from Raging Breath by 50%. Decreases damage, increased damage reduction effect for allies with Dragon Knight Blessing by additional 20%. Can't stack with another Head Dragon Knight. So again, she is actually very viable still in your dragon in PvE. Nobility debuff decreases the defense of the attacking enemy by 20% of the caster's maximum health for 7 turns if the caster survives an attack stacks up 4 times. Okay, past recollection decreases the defense of all enemies by 30% of the caster's maximum health for 10 turns when the caster dies. So again, the effect this takes effect when she dies and gives a decrease of defense by 30% for 10 turns. So again, she's actually a good support hero, but she has to die for this to be effective. Let's move on to her S1. S1, again, not really very impressive of a skill. Touch of Dust, mana 3, deals 525% damage to one enemy. So this actually is a pinpoint damage. S2 has more of a status effect for her skill. So Soul Capture deals 375% damage to one enemy, decreases attack of target by 54% of own attack. So you have to increase her attack so that percentage would be increased as well. Not really increased, but more on as you increase your attack, a certain percentage also increased. So this takes up 9 turns. So again, she's a valuable support for your backline or for your team, and also she decreases attack and she does debuff. So she's one of the more better debuffers in the game, but right now we haven't seen her in action in PvP. That is why she is mostly going to be at number 5. At number 4, we have here D.Va, previously the queen of PvP. She has actually dipped in terms of usage because, again, the meta right now is kind of tankier than it was before, than when we started the game way back a year ago or less than a year ago. So let's take a look at her kit. So again, she also has Dragon Hunter Blessing, so attacks enemies, so she has Finishing Blow too. And what's good about her passive is Crimson Strike increases own critical damage by double. So this is what makes her very effective before in PvP. Right now, she's still kind of effective, but she can be, you know, she can be more of use in your PvP tag. Let's go through her skills. So for S1, she is Acrobatic Dance, deals 76% damage to all enemies, resets turn if a target dies. This was what made her very OP before. Especially when the enemy has some squishy characters, this triggers every time. It's only a 2 mana, you know, skill, and this is really crazy. And by herself, she did a lot of damage before, and she could win the battle for you just by herself. So let's move on to her S2, Tiki Time Bomb, which I still do like. Deals 700% damage to one enemy. A debuff takes effect, so afflicts target with silence for 5 turns. If you don't kill the enemy, that enemy is being silenced. So after 5 turns, afflicts target with Tiki Time Bomb that inflicts damage equal to 163% of own current health. Okay, so again, she is still very useful both for PvE and for PvP. Okay, so Annie here at number 3 is one of the favorite heroes that I have been using from the start. She was actually one of the best heroes coming out when Exosphere started global. So let's take a look at her passive. So she has Mana Utilization 2, increase attack based on allies mana count, gains 1 mana if allies mana count is at 10 or more on own turn. So she has Shell Investigator 2, increase the damage 200% against Monomoss with Fire Barrier. Burning Soul is actually what makes her really crazy. So Mark grants damage immunity to an ally with the highest attack speed. So imagine either Rera gets this. For me, it's Rudley. Sometimes if you have this with Baraka, he actually gets this. And except for self, while increasing critical hit by 300%. So crazy. For 2 turns and gain mana. Gain 3 mana every round. So that fast hero not only gains critical hit 30%, gains mana as well, 3 per round, which is actually, again, very crazy. And also gains damage immunity. So alone for this passive, she is actually very excellent in terms of if you want to pull for her. Let's move on to her S1. So S1 is Crazy Parrot. Deals 100% damage to an enemy, which actually is a good damage. But what this skill is actually giving you is the silence. Afflicts target with silence for 5 turns. After 5 turns, afflicts target with Crazy Parrot that includes damage equal to 100% of own current health. Which is actually crazy because after you silencing them, there's another damage coming in with 100% of own current health. So again, crazy control spell with only one mana and really very good in terms of utility. Has been fantastic in my PvP roster for Wasted Red. So again, she's one of my mainstays still until today. And she has proven her worth locking down enemies with her silence. Again, only for a required mana of one. Next is her unbelievably high damage S2 Explosion Star. Required mana is 5, but it is a burst skill. Deals 357 damage to all enemies, which is actually, again, crazy, crazy damage. Similar, this spell is actually similar to Battery's S2 as well in terms of the damage dealt and a burst spell. Okay, second on our list is going to be Battery. Of course, Battery is going to be a mainstay in terms of your teams if you're carrying Greenland. So mana utilization 3 as well. So it increases attack as well based on allies mana count, kind of similar to Annie. Breath of Mana, over time, front row allies permanently gain 1 mana. Okay, she's actually very good. She supports usually Talia in the front. And if you still have Tantalo in the front, they actually gain 1 mana permanently every round. She actually gives you Tranquil, which most of the people are really a fan of, including me. Grants allies with less attack than self with Tranquil Mark and protects from death 1 time. So again, even though this is highly counterable by Signature Force, this still is an annoying skill to have or annoying passive to give. And next is Heaming Leva. Overtime effect increases health of all allies except the caster by 20%. So again, she gives everybody a buff by 20% in terms of their health. So let's move on to her S1. S1, not really a very good skill, so deals 102 damage to all enemies. But her S2, again, as I've said, deals 357 damage to all enemies, and it's a burst skill, which is Leviathan. Required mana is 5. So her utility and support is actually very good. The only problem with her is that she is actually a frost hero, which she's usually countered by Summer's Blessing. But again, that's we usually have a workaround for that problem. But she is very valuable for her passive. So again, great attack and support general to have on your team. Mana, protection from death, health increase. Okay, so let's move on to our final and our ranked number one hero. So for number one, we have Rudley. Rudley has been underestimated or has been underrated for a couple of months, actually. He actually rose to popularity recently, having seen him in other nation comps like Greenland. You've seen him in Lenombe. Of course, he's from Wasted Red, so you'll see him in Wasted Red. He's all around the place because number one, he is very versatile in terms of damage, again, in terms of giving support, and also HP, defense, you name it. So we'll start with his passive, counter 3. So his counters upon taking damage, gain 1 mana if the target dies, and gain 1 mana if health of the target is 70 or more. And Vanguard, if marked with combat command mark, grants a barrier to self and an ally with the lowest health when the skill strikes an enemy. Okay, so Vanguard, the command mark is given by Garf, but again, if you splash him with other teams, this usually doesn't take effect, which most players do not value the most. Let's go to his S1, which actually his S1 is like similar to Annie in terms of silence. So S1 living shall perish, so again, it's a required mana 1, deals 100% damage to an enemy, which you don't really are looking after. But the debuff flicks target with silencer 5 turns. After 5 turns, it flicks target with the living shall perish that inflicts damage equal to 100% of own current health, which is actually similar to what Annie gives. Vanguard, if you have Vanguard activated, so grants a barrier equal to 29% of own maximum health for 10 turns. Okay, so again, very impressive S1, and for his S2, which is more impressive, Decisive Strike Deity deals 255 damage to all enemies, and what's great about this, it's a burst spell. When the attack hits, it will increase the health of all allies by 122% of own maximum health. So the key is to increase his own health so that he could give a large increase of health to his allies. Again, this is a good substitute if you are lacking a healer. And also, it increases the defense of all allies by 83% of own defense. So this really is a ridiculous spell. Also, if you have Vanguard, grants a barrier equal to 73% of own maximum health for 13 turns. So again, you have increased health, increased defense, and a barrier too. Very, very impressive S2. And you can't go wrong with Redly being splashed with other nations. That is why he is our most ranked Fate Core for the past banner. So more or less, guys, I hope this helped you in terms of deciding who you want to pull for in the current banner that is out, the Choice Fate Core Re for the past banner. And more or less, this is just, guys, my own opinion, so don't hold it against me in terms of how I ranked all of these Fate Core. For those who have reached this far to this video, please do consider subscribing, and also don't forget to click the bell icon and also put a like if you have considered this video very valuable or have helped you in a way. Also, guys, don't forget to put your comments down below if you find this video helpful, and also if you have suggestions. Always take care, guys. Stay safe. This is the Warden, and I'm out here.